Welcome to an enlightening podcast from IslamPodcasts.com. We encourage our listeners to please comment and let us know how we can grow in our knowledge to better serve our community. Please remind your family and friends to also visit IslamPodcasts.com for engaging discussions on current events, Islamic guidance, Quran, tafsir, seerah, and much more.
Today on 5-Minute Fridays, Surah Yusuf and dealing with life's tests. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to 5-Minute Fridays, where we bring you a reminder from the Quran, the Sunnah, or the glorious Islamic history in 5 minutes or less. As we face life's many tests, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us an important reminder in Surah Yusuf. He says, وَاللَّهُ غَالِبٌ عَلَىٰ أَمْرِهِ وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ وَاللَّهُ غَالِبٌ عَلَىٰ أَمْرِهِ And Allah is predominant over his affair, but most of the people do not know. This is from the story of Yusuf alayhi salam, a story with many trials. Out of jealousy, his brothers threw this young boy in a well. First trial. He was kidnapped and sold into slavery, and his master's wife tried to seduce him. Second trial. He was innocent, yet he was thrown in jail. Third trial, subhanAllah. One trial after another. How do you cope? What do you do? Is there a way out? Many trials also befell Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Mecca. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answers by reminding the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and us, وَاللَّهُ غَالِبٌ عَلَىٰ أَمْرِهِ And Allah is predominant over his affair, but most of the people do not know. The ayah has two parts. The first part, that Allah is predominant over his affair, Ibn Kathir explains, this means Allah is dominant over all that exists, that Allah does whatever he wishes, and none can oppose him, not America or any other so-called power. Two, but most of the people do not know, Sa'id bin Jubair said, they don't comprehend his wisdom in his creation, his subtleties, and his action for what he intends, subhanAllah. We face trials as individuals. We face trials as a community, like when the UK government is using the Prevent program to clamp down on practicing Muslims. And we see similar clampdowns in France, Austria, and elsewhere. And our Ummah faces trials abroad. Syria, the Uyghurs, Yemen, huge suffering, refugees, many dead. Some ask, what next? When will this end? Allah reminds us, وَاللَّهُ غَالِبٌ عَلَىٰ أَمْرِهِ وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ That Allah is predominant over his affair, but most of the people do not know. This ayah teaches us to cultivate the Islamic mindset for dealing with trials. It teaches us, one, that tests are part and parcel of life. Question for us is whether we respond by standing firm and following Allah's guidance until his help comes. Two, that Allah is in ultimate control and is the ultimate helper in overcoming any situation, that Allah is on your side. So in situations that look impossible to us, look at the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala versus the power of your opponent, and you see who really is in control. Three, this leads to tawakkul, reliance on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So don't worry. Don't be depressed. Be positive when you face life's trials. Be hopeful of Allah's help. Remember His power and how He helped the believers through the centuries. Number four, Islam teaches sabr, patient perseverance. Sabr is not to sit and do nothing. Sabr is fortitude and obedience while patiently awaiting the outcome. Sabr is acting in obedience to Allah's command when you face trials. So despite the hostile atmosphere in Europe, don't stop teaching Islam to our kids. Don't stop speaking up for our Ummah in Syria and their desire for an Islamic future. Don't stop challenging the lies about Islam. Don't be lazy or heedless and ignore the challenges we face. Allah will ask us, what did you do? What did I do? Knowing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in ultimate control helps us to stand firm for the truth, to stand firm for Islam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable us to understand this ayah, rely on Him, and work for the victory of Islam. Ameen. Please share this video. follow me on Instagram, Facebook, and YouTube, where I release a 5-minute reminder video every Friday morning, inshallah. It's Jumu'ah, send salawat upon our beloved Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammad.
Thank you for listening to this podcast. Podcasts on current events, Islamic guidance, Quran tafsir, and seerah are available at islampodcasts.com, as well as on iTunes. Rate, review, and comment, and let us know how we can grow in our knowledge to better serve our community. Please subscribe, share, and tell a friend about islampodcasts.com.